Welcome back! My name is ballerscuba. This is Video Games Over Time. We are still in 1982. Today, we're going to talk about Joust. The story of Joust takes us back to Williams Electronics. We have talked about Williams Electronics before. Some of their highlights include Defender, Stargate, and Moon Patrol. We last talked about Williams Electronics in our video on Robotron 2084. After the success of Defender, Williams Electronics began looking for new creative staff. One new hire would be John Newcomer, who had previously worked as a toy designer. Newcomer came up with several ideas, including a game based on War of the Worlds. However, that game proved too complicated for the hardware. One concept proved to be feasible, so development began on a game that would run on Defender's hardware. Newcomer came up with a flying game. Thinking of all the things that could fly, Newcomer decided on using birds, based on his love of fantasy and science fiction stories that featured birds. He wanted something majestic, so he decided on an ostrich. He wanted to make a cooperative game, so in order to make the two players distinct, he decided on a stork for the second player. He also decided on vultures for the enemies, believing them to look inherently evil. Because the game changed its flying mechanics from other games, from spaceships to birds, the control scheme had to change with it. Instead of just controlling the flying direction, the player must use a flapping mechanic to keep the birds in the air. Instead of shooting, the players fight their enemies by colliding into them. Space on the game would prove to be limited, so the sound in the game had to be focused on key moments and actions. Bill Futzenreuter, a designer, programmed the artificial intelligence for the enemies. Each different enemy would be programmed differently and would behave differently based on their position in the level. Due to processing limitations, having too many enemies on the screen would cause the enemies to slow down. The art of the game was designed by Janice Hendricks and Python Angelo, while the sound of the game was designed by Tim Murphy and John Kotlarik. Joust is an arcade action game. The player controls a yellow knight riding a flying ostrich with a joystick and a button. The joystick controls the horizontal direction for the flight, and the button flaps the bird's wings. The goal is to defeat the enemy knights on the screen by colliding with them. If the player is higher than the enemy, the player will win the duel. The enemy will then turn into an egg, which can be collected for points. If the egg lands safely and is not collected, a new enemy will hatch. The game can be played with two players. The second player controls a blue knight on a stork. The two players will play together to defeat their common enemies instead of battling each other. Williams Electronics released Joust to arcades in North America on July 16, 1982. They were scared that the new control scheme would scare off new players, and arcades were hesitant to buy the game when it was initially released. That is the short backstory to Joust. With that now told, it's time to play the game for ourselves. And here we are in the game. This is Joust. As you can see, it is a clean machine that doesn't have any high scores on it. You only need 4,000 points in order to get onto the Joust Champions list. That is not difficult. The Daily Buzzards list is a little bit harder to get onto. But you do get an extra mount, an extra life, so to speak, every 20,000 points. And here is Williams Electronics' shiny intro screen. They have been good about that lately. Remember the one from Robotron 2084 as well. They're trying to get the attention of a lot of people in the arcade itself. But then they give us quite the introduction, because this is going to be a different control scheme here. You have to repeatedly press the flap button in order to get up. You don't get a lot of momentum going up on each flap. And once again, you kind of hit them with the lance. That's the collision that happens. And then you have to collect the egg before it goes and hatches a new enemy. We have Bounders, we have Hunters, and we have Shadow Lords. I hope to make it to the spot where we can actually see Shadow Lords, but we will see if I can make it through there. I'm not particularly good at Joust. And then there is the Lava Troll on the bottom. Don't land in the lava. That is death. And then beware of the unbeatable question mark. Pterodactyl. I'm not sure we'll make it to Pterodactyls, but if we make it to Shadow Lords, we'll make it to Pterodactyls. They do show up a little bit earlier. And I think that is the full introduction to the game. You can kind of see the ostrich and the stork between the two enemies. And then, of course, the vulture, between the two players, I should say. And then the vultures for the enemies. All right, so that is kind of the introduction to Joust. You can see Mrs. as number six. That's my goal, to beat Mrs. I don't know Mrs. who, but we're going to try to do what I can here. We're not going to be able to do dual play. I don't have anybody here with me. And the game is particularly difficult. So we're going to stick with one player here. All right. Buzzard bait, wave one. All right, my initial strategy is kind of to hang out near the top. Really? I was lower than him? Start off higher. All right, try to get to the top. Like I said, it takes a bit of getting used to. You have to flap a lot in order to get to the top of the screen. And there we go. All right, let's get this. And get this. Yeah, everything kind of loops around. Let's get back up to the top. All right, just came right at me. Up, 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 up. There we go. You guys are just gonna keep coming at me like that. It'll make this a lot easier for me. How did I miss? What are you doing? Well, he fixed himself somehow. Up, up, there we go. And we've made it to wave number three. As you can see, we're up to 12,550. We're doing pretty well for ourselves, even though that first one didn't work out all that well for me. Okay, there's one. I'm gonna avoid you. No! I couldn't get up high enough quick enough. Where am I spawning? Okay. It's not too bad. Nope. Bounced right into the other guy. Okay, start up there, huh? No! Get away. Oh, I didn't even see you coming. Right, let's just collect this egg. Got you. No, I hit the top. Thy game is over. All right, enter thy name, huh? I think it's just initials. That's what we saw before, so we'll go with that. Oh, nope, it was full name. And then initials down here. And we got 15,000, so not the best. And I didn't get to see Pterodactyls or Shadow Lords. So of course, I am going to try this again. And it gets particularly tricky because of the momentum in the game. It is very difficult, I think, to change your momentum. Oh, same height? I thought I was way higher than him. He just kind of fixed it last minute there. Alright, get you. Get that. If you catch it in the air, you get more points. How was I lower than him? How? Alright, come on. Up here. Look, I was way higher. You gotta be like way higher than that. Alright, let's get back up here. Yeah, it just takes a lot of momentum to change. Or it takes a lot of work to change your momentum, I should say. Just land on top of them. That way there's no question who's higher than the other one. Oh, just missed him. Now let's get down here. I also find it weird that the ostrich can run faster than it can fly. Then again, ostriches can't actually fly. No! Get me out of here. So I guess that it would make sense for the ostrich to run faster than it can fly. But it's just all weird. All right, we got our first pterodactyl. Yeah, it was lower than me. It just charged at me. That is not good for me. Lost a life that way. All right, and back this way. No survival points awarded. All right, but we made it to stage 3 again. Not seeing any Shadow Lords, but there's just so many enemies. All right, one. Two and three. No! Okay. I had to dodge him, he was too high. No! No. No, he still got me! How dare you! Oh, they're going so fast. Is that a Shadow Lord up there? It might have been. No, I think that's just the second level enemy. That was even? I'm sorry, he landed on top of me. No! They hatched a new one. And there I go. Alright, so we got over 20,000 points, which got me a new mount. And here comes the pterodactyl. I'm gonna die. Get back here. No! Alright, well, I got a decent score. I think I got one more run in me. We'll see if I can't do a little bit better. We'll put my actual name here. Oh, nope. Enter my name. It's still just the three letters. And then enter my initials. There we go. SMD did it. So my initials go up top. So the first one goes in Joust Champions, the second one goes in Daily Buzzards. That is weird. All right, let's do one more run, see what I can do. I believe that there is a way to defeat the pterodactyls, but I think I just have to land on top of them. I have to, like, descend on them. And that is much easier said than done. Up, up, up. No! Get back, alright. There we go. And that's all it takes to get onto the daily high scores. Come for me. You guys keep on going in a set pattern, that would be great. Got it in the air. There we go. And then get up. There we go. 3,000 survival points. Stay up near the top here. Obviously, being up is better. But they can get higher than me. They're just better. They're just better. Still higher than me, huh? Oh, get over there. Nope, too low. That's why it's dangerous mixing in with them. Alright, we'll get that. Nope. Too low. They're just kind of blocking me here. Can I, yeah, I can get you. No, that game is over. Yeah, so just initials. Again, don't get to enter my name. Because I didn't get the high score of the day. Alright, but that was a little bit short, so let's do it one more time. Let's see what I can do. The control scheme just takes a while to get used to, because the momentum is so strong. It is so difficult to adjust where I am, and all right, there we go. So difficult to adjust where I am, and they seem to be able to adjust better than I can. And you can see when there's a lot of enemies, the game prioritizes me. No, get up. No, 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 no. There we go. Nope. No, get out of there. Somehow I got that. Okay. Wave three. This is the one with just the massive amount of enemies. As our safe little spot from the lava disappears. Oh, jeez. Yeah, I went over him. Do I go up? Do I dare go up there? I have to eventually. No! We're gonna save him! Nope. Too high. And then the lava goes, eats that one, which is fine. Alright. Get here. Pterodactyl is back! And I died before I even got to it. Alright, can I get you? Thank you. And then. Pterodactyl again. No, no, damn it. So difficult. Okay, back to wave four. Unless I can get a lot of points, this is my last life. No! Get up! There, I got the hard one, supposedly. Yeah, they're flying a little bit too close to the lava there. There we got another hard one, and he was too high for me. But I did get just 20,000 points. So, that worked out nicely for me. To get up. As there's a pterodactyl. Alright, yeah, that is all that I'm gonna be able to do today. Clearly not gonna get too much better than that. I did before, but not by a lot. I made, you know, two entries on the Daily Buzzards list. Almost got the highest score. Very close. Just, 260 points away. But that is Joust. That is not easy. So that is the game now played, and with the game now played, let's talk about how it holds up today. Playing the game today, I do have to say that the game is fun. I enjoyed playing Joust for as long as I felt I could, or as long as I felt that I was making good runs There's definitely going to be a point in this game where you start playing worse. And a lot of that has to do with the flat mechanic of the game. I found myself just basically button mashing the flat button the entire time that I played, not really trying to do much else, just trying to get in the air, trying to get in position where I needed my character to be, and failing at that more often than I succeeded. So I would say that the game is difficult, but that might just be from my perspective. If you have a ton of practice and you can get that flapping down, maybe it will be better for you and easier for you. But for me, going through, it just felt like I was mashing the button, hoping that my character would go slightly where I wanted him to go. I did look up what needs to happen with pterodactyl. It is possible to kill the pterodactyl. You just have to lance it in the mouth. There is a debate on whether the mouth has to be open or closed, but it is a very small window of where your lance has to be in order for that pterodactyl to be defeated. But it is possible to do that. Not a lot of people can, apparently. It requires a lot of skill in the game. So if you have a lot of time to practice, maybe you can get the pterodactyl. But in the meantime, I would just avoid it altogether. I did also look up the high score. The high score is just max score. There is a max that the game will track. And then after that, it doesn't keep track anymore. The game, I would say, is difficult, but it is one that is enjoyable. There is a reason that I feel that the game went for a co-op mode, a cooperative mode, where two players go for the same goal together instead of fighting against each other. And I think that is because the game is difficult, and it would help to have somebody else with you along the way, trying to take out what ends up being quite a lot of enemies. And quite a lot of enemies that seem to be able to move better than at least I can, if not the player character in general. In terms of overall concept, Joust is kind of strange. I didn't want to necessarily say that in the intro, that it's just kind of weird, but, you know, telling somebody after the fact what Joust is odd. It's, well, you're a medieval knight with a lance on top of an ostrich, which can fly, and you're lancing your enemies that are also knights, but they're on vultures. And you got to make sure that you're higher than them, because that's how you win. It's an odd concept. It's something that stands out, definitely, but it's definitely not one that picked up over time. It just kind of stayed here. And there's definitely a risk to the original concept, and I think that it worked in this game. I think that the game overall, the gameplay is good, and I think that carries over the initial oddity of what it is you are doing in the game. In terms of graphics, I would say that they're pretty good. Of course, we're coming off of pole position in our last video, so it's kind of hard to compare this game to that. But I could recognize what I was riding. I could tell that what I was riding was an ostrich, and it wasn't an eagle or a hawk or anything like that. It was definitely an ostrich. When we saw the little intro, we could see that it was a stork that the second player was flying, and we could see that the enemies were flying vultures. Those were very clear, so I have to say that the graphics were good as a result. Could they have been better? Sure, some sort of background would have been nice instead of the black background, but overall I do have to say that the graphics are good for the time. The sound also is particularly good. It doesn't necessarily ring of what is happening on the screen, right? That I'm lancing somebody, or that a pterodactyl is showing up. It doesn't necessarily scream that to me, but they were recognizable sounds that are pretty iconic. Somebody that played this game a lot, they will recognize those sounds outside of the game. It will be familiar to them because the sound design is particularly good, I would say. Could have been better? Sure. I don't know what sounds I would ask for an ostrich to make, but the ones that they did were at least recognizable. You could tell when something good happened versus something bad happened. It was a little weird for me to, you know, kind of struggle with who's higher than the other when collisions did happen. It seemed to change last minute a lot, and that was a strange thing to happen. But overall, I would say that this game is fun and it's worth revisiting. It's definitely one of the first games that have a co-op mode, and it's hard to put, you know, a score, a number to quantify how fun that can be, because it all depends on the second person. So if the two of you work well together, this is a game definitely I would recommend to people working and playing together to reach that common goal of defeating all the buzzards and all the enemies, all the vultures. This is a game that is worth revisiting. Definitely. It is definitely an iconic one for the time because of the odd nature and odd lore, I guess, of the game. But it is one that is definitely worth looking back upon and seeing what you can do in a difficult game that is definitely different than the other games that we have been playing at the time. This is an odd one, but I would recommend it. And that is my modern take on the game. Despite the initial hesitancy, the game would prove to be popular. Williams Electronics would sell 26,000 units of Joust. The game would prove to be popular enough to warrant international releases. Williams Electronics would release Joust in Europe in January 1983. It would take until 1984, however, for the game to be released in Japan. As time has gone on, opinions of Joust have been positive. It is often cited among the greatest games of all time. The game's original concept, the simple controls, and the ability to play with a second player at the same time are seen as the highlights of the game. Joust would prove to be influential as well. In 1983, Williams Electronics released a pinball machine based on the game. The game would inspire ports, remakes, and a sequel. Elements of the game would be used in several games in the future. We will keep an eye on these as we continue. Looking ahead, with another successful video game boosting their profits, Williams Electronics would continue to develop video games, and we will hear from them again in the future. John Newcomer would also continue to develop video games, and we will hear from him again. As for the other developers, although they would continue to work at Williams Electronics, many would switch to pinball machines, and we will most likely not hear from them again. That will do it for the story of Joust for now. My name is Baller Scuba. This has been Video Games Over Time. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in our next video when we play a movie.